December 21, 2012. The end date of the sophisticated long count calendar created by the ancient Maya in Central America. Countless books and websites, magazine articles and newspaper headlines debate its meaning, with enthusiasts in two camps: those forecasting apocalypse, the end of time, and those who see a coming renewal, a rebirth of consciousness. Adding fuel to the debate, some scientists see the increasing number of natural disasters in recent years as evidence of a catastrophic climax of events in 2012. How much of what we're hearing is science, and how much is superstition?
The December 21st, 2012 date is gaining ground in the popular media, and there is a lot of apocalyptic hype around it. But it's sort of an indication that one is not looking deep enough into the phenomenon.
One of the great challenges that poses us is this question of 2012. What does this mean to us?
There are texts and traditions coming down to us from which suggests this is not just the end of a calendrical epoch, but the end of an entire age of the Earth and of everything that has been built and accumulated in the last 5,000 years, that this too will come to an end.
If that were the only thing I knew, that it was a consistent ancient prophecy, I would note it. I might shudder in the dark of night, but I would leave it. If it were not for the coincidence of contemporary solar physics with the sunspots climaxing in 2012.
We're in the midst of a 2012 mania, being as spiritually starved as we are and subject to such a terrible world around us, we look for explanations. And it's what motivated me to talk a little bit more about the scientific side of some of these explanations.
When you look at the totality of the evidence from coming from different ages, different times periods, and different sources, including scientific, that seem to pretend that something pretty important may be happening around the year 2012, then I think it's time that we pay serious attention to this.
Modern man perceives time as a linear progression with a fixed past, present, and future. The Maya, on the other hand, understood time as something more fluid, and they believed that periods of time would be repeated through a series of world ages. The Maya were far from unique in their understanding of time as repeating cycles. In fact, many cultures around the world have had similar ideas about world ages, with highs and lows, beginnings and endings, apocalypse and renewal.
When my book came out in 1998, Maya Cosmogenesis 2012, it sort of begged the question of whether or not these profound insights of the Maya were known to other world traditions. And so I took the whole galactic alignment thesis on a world tour and looked at other traditions. Basically, it does seem that the astronomical cycles and the galactic alignment information is deeply encoded in Western traditions.
Mythologies, legends, everywhere from the Asia to Americas to Europe to Africa, talk about periods of catastrophic dissolution of advanced civilizations, of civilizations in general.
A lot of indigenous cultures around the world have a kind of coherent understanding of what this time means. So the Hopi in Arizona talk about this as being the transition from the fourth world to the fifth world, according to their oral prophecies. And then the classical Mayan civilization, they put forth the idea that 2012 is the end of a great cycle.
So you can look at Mithraism, you can look at Egypt, you can look at Islamic astrology, with the doctrine of the lunar nodes. It almost seems like this galactic alignment information is a very ancient idea.
It's really hard to look at any ancient mythological system without realizing that they thought in cyclical terms, not in linear terms. So literally, as we would put it today, what goes around comes around. My interest was, could there have been a forgotten episode in human history? And I began to find the evidence forcing me to look at a period of about 12,000 years ago, or it was the end of the last ice age. And much in the mythology seemed to suggest that the cataclysm that occurred then in some way was going to come back. And so I found that my quest was not only for the beginning of human civilization, but also for the end of human civilization, and that the ancients seemed to be passing down some kind of warning, or perhaps taking into account that human civilization would change greatly, that cultures would change, that languages would be lost, looking for a universal system of communication. And it seemed to me that they looked to the heavens for that system, because the stars will always be above us and have always been above us. And if it's possible to encode your message by using the changing patterns of the stars, then you might hope that at some distant date someone else might be able to read that message. And this was when I came across the ancient Maya. The Maya were avid stargazers and appear to have inherited a body of astronomical knowledge from the Olmecs before them. And so it's in the Olmec monuments that we get the first hint of a calendar system. And that calendar system is perfected into a fine-tuned device by the ancient Maya. And like so much of ancient thought, it is cyclical in nature, that they are repeating periods of history just over 5,000 years in length. And it's just a fact that the latest cycle of the Maya calendar begins somewhere before 3000 BC and culminates on the 21st of December 2012. For the Maya, the idea that what was there before is lost and then returns would have made perfect sense. And it's this sense of a cyclical cataclysm linked to a cyclical rebirth that I found most eerie, really, and spooky in the Mayan tradition.
The Mayans were extraordinary astronomers. They were able to foretell heavenly phenomena centuries into the future.
What is crucial is the position of our sun against the background of the stars at the winter solstice, the 21st of December. And what we find is that the sun is rising against the background of the dead center of the Milky Way in our time. And the Maya knew this, and they knew that people would be able to observe it. And they're saying, this is a very important moment, take account of this. Realize that you live in a time of change and a time of transition.
The prophecies of the Maya are shared by other ancient American cultures, including the Hopi and the Inca. Psychologist and author Alberto Villoldo has spent many years with the Peruvian elders of the Andes and has been able to bring back their warning of a catastrophic time for humanity, but also the possibility of a new golden age.
Humans have become a parasite on this planet. I mean, we are committing matricide. We're killing our mother who supports us. The Earth is designed to support a population of under a billion people riding bicycles to work, not 7 billion driving SUVs. So the prophecies speak about this time of a culling of humanity, of a harvesting of souls, and of a decimation of large parts of the human race, and the beginning of a millennium of gold, of tremendous opportunity. They're very optimistic. They're very hopeful for the planet. They're not that optimistic for humanity at large. Had a shaman tell me one time, Alberto, we're going to miss our white brother. So they speak about a correction and a bringing back of balance to the earth. The way that this was announced was with the wrath of our father, the sun. They speak about the drying of the high mountain lagoons, the melting of the glaciers. This was to be the beginning of an apocalyptic era. But the prophecy spoke that the world would be set right again with the new planetary alignment that would take place.
12/21/12 prediction of the Mayan calendar is predicated on the assumption that the solar system travels around the galaxy in a predictable path, and that on that particular date, we will eclipse the center of the galaxy. There will be the Earth, here's the Sun, here's the center of the Milky Way.
We'll be cut off from a direct connection to the center of the Milky Way galaxy. And we will therefore be deprived of a certain energetic sustenance that we require for continuing to live as we have.
What could that mean? The best description was given me, and I did go down to Guatemala and spend some time with Mayan shamans, and they related it to when you lose power in your house, for some appliances and some functions, there's no problem. When the power comes back on, the lights go back on. But there are certain things, the VCR clock and the microwave, that are thrown out of kilter, even for being cut off from that sustenance for just a second. And that is their physical explanation for the danger of this eclipse.
The timing of it means that all of the heavens will be aligned behind us to enable us to bring forth a new time into the planet, a time of possibility, of opportunity, of healing. I attended the most recent reading of the prophecy in 1998, where they were taking the pulse of the planet to see where we were within the division that had been received by the ancient ones. And in that reading of the prophecy, they said that the upheaval and the turmoil was to be far greater than had been anticipated, with the possibility of cascading crises. Not a single crisis, but two or three that would cascade off each other, bringing about dramatic corrections in the Earth's climate, making parts of the planet inhospitable and uninhabitable.
I think that there is a very real possibility that around 2012 we'll see a shifting of the paradigm and more people will be becoming aware of who we are, where we came from, our place in the universe. And then that would pretty much coincide with the Mayan prediction that we'll be into a new age.